Howdy ding dong doody guys, welcome back to Let's Play Ghost Trick Phantom Detective. With me, TapersCrazy, where we last left off, we tried saving Lynn's life again, but what happened is we ended up coming towards the guy that drove a van through the chicken shop. We're essentially trying to save his life now by the look, so let's have a quick look around the area. Do we care about this flashing light? I'm not entirely certain. Unless we climb this seat. There's not a lot we can do at the moment. Ooh, there's an idea bulb. Hey, this place. This is a place that white suited inspector phoned tonight.
This is a parking lot of a park on the east side of town. It's been years.
You know this park?
Yeah, I used to play here a lot when I was little. But then, one day, I swore I'd never set foot in this park ever again.
Whoa, those are some really deep, dark feelings there. I wonder what happened.
Hold it. Don't give me that. The ghost doesn't see it. Have a foot to set bit. It's just a figure of speech.
What kind of nitpicker do you think I am?
Anyway, whatever. Let's get started.
Okay, let's do that. I won't press her about the other thing right now. Yeah, you probably should. Okay, well, I can't really do a lot. Doesn't look like the detective is going to come.
Might as well turn it off. It's pretty loud.
What the?
Okay, maybe I should raise the seat. Because if you're going to sit in it, I might be able to get him to lean down or something. Okay, there's not a lot I can do, so I think I'm going to have to wait for this guy to come over.
That's Lynn, our rookie detective. What's he doing at Point X? Could it be just a coincidence? Bree's got an APB on her a little while ago. Something about an extremely important case, is extremely important witness, currently extremely on the run. Now what? Should I report this to Inspector Cabanella?
Wow, they put out an APB on me.
Apparently, they're calling you a fugitive.
Ah!
You naughty girl, you. What? You naughty girl. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to make you upset.
A girl's heart is a very delicate thing, you know.
This one, the girl a giant chicken couldn't even kill.
It did kill me!
Okay.
Yes, come over here!
Ooh! A thing. Oh, maybe I can reclimb the seat and move them. Okay. Maybe not. Oh, am I going to launch them up in the air now? I may have just screwed myself. Maybe if I turn this on. Oh, here we go! Okay. Does he have something that I can latch onto? Yo, can I latch onto your hat there, friendo? Oh?
What are these doing here?
Oh no, I want to be under glasses! Come back! Quick. If he's going to be moving about anyway. Ah, let's see who's on this phone.
What's the matter?
Detective Prince, this is Memory.
What's the matter? It's not time for your regular report.
Listen to this. There's a suspicious couple in the bar upstairs. I'm going to put a ladybug on him.
A ladybug? You mean a listening device? Don't do anything to blow our cover. Inspector Carbonello will be furious.
But they're doing all kinds of suspicious whispering. We have to find out what they're saying. You can pick up the signal from your van. Check out the conversation for me, would you?
Oh, so she's the popo.
Alright, fine. So you're going on something. You don't know there's no stopping you.
Thanks, later, man.
Hold on. Did you see a customer come in just now? A young woman with red hair and red boots.
That restless, suspicious chick, sure.
Suspicious?
I mean, come on. As soon as she sat down, she ordered 3 glasses of water in a row. And she spilled the 2nd glass on the table.
Okay, fine. Keep your eye on her, too, if you would.
You got it. Oh, wow. That waitress was an undercover agent.
And she apparently thought you were pretty suspicious, too.
Oh, yeah, sorry. I was really thirsty, so, you know.
No, I don't know.
Anyway, did you hear what I heard about the listening device? We have to do something about that bug.
So should we stay here or follow up on the waitress? Looks like it's time to make a decision. Yeah, let's follow up on the waitress. I'm sure we can go back in time if we need to.
If we need to do anything else with that guy. Oh god, it's the chef! Got a new phone number. Oh, it's a good thing he gives me pictures, isn't it?
Hey, look where we are!
The heart of a chicken kitchen, eh?
Nando's.
Yep, or as most people say, the kitchen.
Oh, the key to preventing the accident is here somewhere.
Oh, I bet it will be. You know what they say, where there's smoke and chicken, there's fire.
Now that you mention it, it is pretty smoky in here. It is, isn't it? It's like the vents aren't working. Okay, what does this do?
What's wrong?
I can't seem to raise this switch. It won't budge.
Yeah, well, not surprising. This whole place is sticky with grease. I bet it must be stuck.
Yeah, it does feel pretty sticky. But if the switch were already raised, I bet I could manage to lower it. Well, why would I need it raised then? Scrunch and stretch. Ugh. Ah! Really?
Hey, look what she's doing. Do you think that could be...
Yeah, she's probably planting the ladybug. Now that I think about it, isn't this waitress's meddling that starts the whole chain of events?
The detective wouldn't have gotten his ears blown out and wouldn't have crashed.
In other words, we're witnessing it with our own eyes. The cause of a huge disaster, slowly being planted in a chicken.
Hey, I just had a good idea.
About what to do about the ladybug?
No, I was thinking we could let her get crushed under the chicken instead of me.
I can't tell if you're kidding. At any rate, now you've seen the root cause of the accident.
And all I have to do now is think of a way to take care of it.
Okay. The pot. Rock this kettle. It certainly is smoky in here. Oh, is she gonna do something with the switch? Yeah, as soon as she flips that, I'm...
Put it back into it!
Okay. I wonder why they were turned off anyway. Normally the chef would turn them on when we come in. Okay. Let's turn this off. Dial. What are those things down there? I would like to know. Ooh! Pedal. Operate. Ah!
Hey, what's up with this lazy Susan? It's acting up today. Maybe it's out of sorts because I was spinning around on it yesterday.
Interesting thing to do for a lady her age.
Maybe it's out of sorts. Maybe it's out of sorts. How about thinking maybe it might be broken?
But it really isn't broken. It's just as ghosts.
What are you doing?
Can't you tell? I thought I'd give it a little spin.
Oh, I get it. You're trying to get him away from planting with ladybug. But it seems to be making her all more determined.
I guess this isn't going to work. I'm trying to think. You know what I'm thinking at the moment is... I need to get her to keep using that switch. And then eventually, hopefully this guy will put a chicken on the other plate. And then I can do a swap. Yes, indeed. Indeed. Okay. So I'm going to let her plant it. And then do a swap. Okay. Just waiting for her to get it done. Because there's no point in me doing all that if she's not put it in there yet. Point being, she needs to think she's taking a chicken with a bug in it. I think. God, will you get on with it, love? Jesus. Might as well just play about with a shirt when I'm waiting. Oh no, that's my route across the kitchen. Nope. Put it back. Put it back! Come on. Well, no, she can't put it in there. She's done it before.
Fair. All set.
Oh, no, 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 man. You're supposed to give me the chance to do it. Oh, man. I need to rewind. Whoops. Okay. Fine. Fine. But I was just waiting just because I wanted her to make... I wanted her to put it in there. I was hoping like she'd put it in there, then she'd do something for a few seconds. And that would give me the chance to do the swap. But no, I guess apparently, once that chicken gets put on there, I'll turn the fans on. Or off. On? Off? Essentially, so it gets smoky and she gets distracted. Okay. Actually, let me prepare the room. By that I mean move his shirt. And then, so what I'm going to do is, once that guy's put that chicken on there, I'm going to turn the fans on, off, so it gets smoky. Okay, there we go. Good. I wish I could cook a chicken like that. Yeah, are you supposed to cook a full chicken on a hob like that? Okay, let's turn these off. And then quickly make my way around to the other side of the room. Waiting for this guy to drop his hat down so I can get on the Lazy Susan. Okay. Kind of an interesting concept though, but like a conveyor belt of chicken essentially. I just needed to put it in. Is it in? Okay. Hopefully she said, oh yes, you can see the ladybug on the chicken. Like the flashing thing. Hopefully that means it's in there.
There, all set.
Perfect. I'm a genius, I amaze myself. There, how about that?
The ladybug is still sitting on the table. We did it.
Goddamn right I did. We. La la la, chicken! The water's so beautiful, la chicken! This is a good radio station. I took a bite, my heart swelled with pride, and I got the goosebumps. What the heck is this? I'm consumed with the love of consuming you, la la la. What? It still crashes into the shop. Man, this radio station sucks. Well, it looks like you've escaped the fate of being hammered by your horrible hen.
Yes, but I still haven't escaped the worst darkness of this terrible night. I shot you, didn't I?
Must have been some sort of complicated set of circumstances that made you do it.
It's never okay to shoot a person, no matter what the circumstances.
Hey, shouldn't that be my line? But anyway... You're investigating a case, and I was supposed to give you information on that case. Maybe it's time you told me about it. Tell me about the case you're looking into.
Yes, I guess I should. But let's go back to the new present first.
Okay, sure. Alrighty. Back in the new present, the delicious aroma of chicken fills the air. But I'm still thinking about Lynn. I wonder if she's still waiting for a chicken to be served. I decided to go see her and ask all the questions that were still consuming me. Okay, I just need to get back to the front house, don't I? Hey, chicken guy, drop your hat, please. He has got a funky nose, doesn't he? He's like a seagull or something. I've got to say, that's a pretty amazing way to store... hot sauce, or whatever it's put on there, peri peri sauce. Investigation, basement, guard room, and the chicken kitchen front of house. So what's the kitchen called? The chicken kitchen kitchen? Oh god, it gets confusing. What if there's a kitchen in the kitchen? Kitchenception. Okay. The disastrous accident has been completely erased. Once again, I've saved a red-headed detective from death. Saved Lynn. the criminal who stole my life. One question in particular hangs heavy on my mind. Why did she shoot me? Until I know the answer, I'll never be satisfied. Okay, she's still sat there. Oh, there we go. Did she learn to eat from Jowd? Meanwhile, Lynn's appetite is apparently foremost in her mind. A golden brown chicken sits on the table in front of her. Until she eats the whole thing, she'll probably never be satisfied. Alrighty. How do I get over there? Is there a nice little route? Let's read my thought bubble. Is Lynn having a serious talk with that detective? Nah, she's just gobbling down chicken. How did the detective know to stake out this restaurant tonight? I better see if I can get some information. But more importantly, I have lots of questions about Lady Detective. Okay, will she come and... No, okay.
I didn't know you were here, Detective Range. Come to see me, did you? Oh, that's so sweet.
Oh, hi, Memory. Don't mind us. Just pretend we're not here.
Why don't you try some chicken while you're here?
No, thanks. Just watching Lynn eat is quite enough for me.
So, how did it turn out with my ladybug?
Oh, that listening device? Well, let's see. I thought the gentleman had a very nice singing voice. Sorry, but we're in the middle of an important talk. Could you leave us to it?
But you guys are the ones who called me over.
Odd girl.
I agree.
Me too.
Can I... Am I close enough to hear that? She's talking to the detective quietly while she stuffs her face. But I'm too far away to hear what she's saying. Better get closer. There's nowhere else I can go. Will you bring your damn table over, love? There's nothing I can latch onto.
Did you decide you want some chicken or me after all?
We didn't call you.
Wait a minute. Is that you, Cecil?
There's a good detective. She's figured it out.
If I'm coming over here, don't forget you have to ring the bell 3 times. What are you talking about? Never mind, it's not important.
Yeah, pay no attention to us. We're not even here.
I'll make you notice me someday, detective. You'll see.
Yes, okay, 3 times, I remember.
Oh, girl.
I agree.
Me too. Okay, ring it 3 times. Will she bring the jug? Yay, she fetched a pail of water.
Did you decide you want some chicken or me after all?
We didn't call you. Sorry, but could you give us some privacy?
No, stay right there. Huh? I have a crucial moment with this chicken here. I'll need to pour some water if it starts going down wrong.
Lynn, you have to risk your life over chicken, you know.
He's right. Look at her attacking that thing. Anyway, I better move now while I have the chance. Okay, indeed. Thank you very much, Lynn. She's paying attention. That's funny. Even though I just saved that detective, he doesn't have a call. Not like the one Lynn has, or that valiant little doggy missile. That is interesting, actually. I thought the ones I save are supposed to develop a call when they're alive again. I guess I still have things to learn about these powers of the dead. Or is it because he wasn't conscious?
Well, I'm heading back. Lots of things to do, you know.
Yeah, like washing dishes and planting bugs.
Someday I'll plant a big one on you, detective.
That sounds like a nice promise, I suppose.
Oh, girl.
I agree.
Me too. Why aren't we saying the same thing over and over again?
Okay, we're going to continue this conversation in the next episode because I'm out of time in this one. So, thanks for watching this, guys. Hope you enjoyed it.
Remember to like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you all in the next video.